everyone, it's Olivia from Girlybunches, and in this week's video I'm going to be showing you how to make this really cute Santa's hat egg cozy. And I'm holding this very carefully because inside here is a real egg and it's not boiled or anything, and yeah, it could get messy if I drop it, so I'll just pop it on one more time and show you. This is super cute and it's going to be great for maybe for Christmas morning or just a little gift for someone. And it's a really simple little project. Now I'm just going to take this egg away from the proceedings so that I don't accidentally drop the egg, because that's the sort of thing I can do with quite easily. And I just want to quickly show you my lovely egg cup that was made by my dad. And yes, he makes lots of lovely wooden things and he sells them in his shop, and I'll put a link down below to his shop. So anyway, moving on to the egg cozy, I think this is really cute and it's all made in one piece. If I just turn that bit down, and this is made in the round, so I've not shown this to you before, and I've just added this little pom-pom at the top, and I made that using this clover pom-pom maker, so I will show you how to use that in the video as well. And obviously I've used some red and some cream cotton coloured yarn. You could use whatever colours you wanted to. This doesn't have to be a Santa's hat, obviously. It could be multicoloured for just all the year round, but this is just going to be a fun Christmas project to make. So when you're working in the round, you don't stop and slip stitch into the first stitch of that round. You just work the next round straight away into the top of the previous round, which gives you this sort of step, which you will have, you can't avoid it. The only way to stop have that is by not doing working in the round. But what it does do is that it prevents you from having a seam running obviously through your project. So if I turn this round slowly, you can see that you can't see that seam round. So when you have something like an egg cozy that's going to be seen from all sides, it's quite nice to have it so that you don't see that seam. Okay, so what we're going to need to make our little hat is some, well, Santa's hat. There's definitely going to need some cream and some red yarn. I'm using just normal double knit cotton. I want to keep calling it cotton. It's not double knit acrylic, run of the mill. Nothing fancy, and I'm using my trusty 4mm hook as per usual. You're also going to need a nice darning needle, one again not with a too sharp a point. If you're going to add a pom-pom, you don't have to use this clover pom-pom maker. You can cut out two circles of card. There's loads of videos on YouTube on how to make pom-poms, but I'm just going to use this because it's quick and convenient. Obviously you're going to need scissors. If you're working in the round, you're going to need a stitch marker of some sort. But now what I tend to do is just use a piece of contrasting cotton, and that will make more sense when I get going. So what we need to do is get going. So we're going to start at the top and we work our way down. So this is our first row of stitches and this will be our last. So I'm just going to quickly show you the workings out. And I don't want you to worry about that, because I'm going to type them up nicely and put them on my blog. So I'll put a link down below to that to show you. You might find that might be quite helpful whilst we're going along. So this project starts with a magic loop, and we're going to just wrap the yarn around our finger twice, put the hook underneath and pull that first loop through and just do a slip stitch like that. And now we've got our loop to work into, and what we need to do is do one chain, and then we're going to do 5 double crochet. I've just zoomed in a little bit more there so you can see what we're doing. So I've done the one chain and we're going to do 5 double crochets. Now you may know those as singles, but I'm British so I call them doubles. So I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just going to take the hook out, because what we need to do is we need to tighten up this magic loop. So I'm just going to hold that there and pull this tail, and that brings that up round. And if we were working as we would normally do, we would slip stitch here and then work, so that would bring us up, and then work around again to bring us to the same level. But what we're going to do is just carry on working our stitches. So we're not going to join it, we're just going to work our next stitch into the top of our first stitch. So this stage is quite critical. And you do have to do quite a bit of counting when you're working in the round. So you see this V on the top, that's the top of our stitch. So we're going to work 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got our 5 stitches. But what we're going to do is we're going to work 2 double crochets into the top of each one of these stitches. So need to be careful where you're going to put that stitch, because don't forget we did a chain here, so that does look a little bit like a stitch, but we're not going to work into there, it's there. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to take my hook, put that back in there, tighten that up, and there we go, we're going to go into the top of that stitch there. It's a bit tight this first round, so go steady. And what we're going to do is 2 into each one of the stitches we've already made. So that will give us 10 stitches altogether. So we've counted 5, and then there's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, and then the last 2 into the last stitch will give us 10, 9, 10. Okay, take the hook out. Now you can see it's sort of turning into a spiral, and that's what we want. It's working in the round, so you don't ever have a join, you just keep working around and around. And it's effectively a big spiral, which is why you end up with this step when you add another colour, but that's the way it is. But it does give you, like I said, this nice seamless effect. What I recommend doing now is adding your stitch marker. So I'm going to take a piece of contrasting yarn, and I'm just going to tie a little knot at the end, because we're going to be taking this out once we've finished, but we just need to tie a knot in one end. And I'm going to thread my darning needle, and I'm going to turn it over, so where the tail is, so that's the back and that's the inside of the work. I'm just going to poke my darning needle up through the middle, just gently take out the needle, and then what we've got is our stitch marker that's going to be, we're going to use to work our way up our project as we go. Now I find this probably the easiest way to keep a track of where the row actually starts, because even though it's a continuous row, there are a certain number of stitches you need to do on each row. I really hope I'm not confusing everybody. It will make more sense when I get going. So we've done our first 2 rounds, and our third round is going to be 1 double crochet into the top of all of the stitches we've already made. So we've counted 10, so if I do 1 in each of those stitches, that will also be 10. So I find counting and using the stitch marker the best way of making sure you've got the right number of stitches. It might also be helpful to you to write down how many stitches you should be doing for each row. And when I write the pattern out, I will put in brackets at the end of the row of the line of how many stitches you should have just done in that previous round. We need to do 1 into the top of each of these stitches. So I've just pulled that marker over there. Like that, and that's our next stitch to work in. So I'm just going to pull that over there, and I'm just going to carry on. So this is going to be 1 in each of these. So that's 1. It is a bit tricky when you start off. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight, nine, and then we come back round to here, 10, and we can stop there because we can see that that's where our stitch marker indicates to stop, and it's starting to curl up, and that's great, that's what we want. We want it to make that dome shape, that hat shape. So that's our first three rounds done. Now I'm going to take my stitch marker, I'm going to pull it over and then carry on working my stitches. So that's my next one to work into, and I know now where to stop once I finish my fourth round, sorry. Okay, so for the next round we're going to increase our stitches by 5. So we've started off with 5, and each time we increase, an increasing round will increase by 5. So to do that, we're going to do one double crochet into the next stitch, and then we're going to do, so that's there, and then we're going to do 2 double crochets into the next stitch along, and then we're going to repeat that 4 more times. So what we've got there is 3 stitches. So 3 times 5 is 15. So we've increased that, we're going to increase this round by 5 stitches, so that's 10 plus 5 is 15. So again, 1 into the next one along, 2 into the next one along. So that gives us 6, and we're going to do 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Right, so now we've got our stitch marker. I'm going to put that over the back, and then we're going to do 1 into each one of those stitches along, so that'll be 15 double crochets altogether. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oops. 12, 13, 14, and there's our 15. Then we know where to stop. And I'll just take the hook out and show you what we've got. We've started to get the point of the hat. It's very cute. It's quite fiddly at the moment, but it will get less fiddly. So I'm going to take my stitch marker and pull that forward like that, and then this time we're going to increase by 5 again. So we're going to do 1 double crochet here and 1 double crochet there, so that's 1 in the first 2 and then 2 in the third one, and then we'll repeat, so that will give us 4 stitches, and then we'll repeat that 4 more times to give us 20 stitches altogether. And I'm just going to put my hook back in. So the first 2 stitches will have 1 double crochet in. 1, 2, and then in that one there we'll have 2 stitches. So that's 3, 4. And then we'll repeat that 4 more times till we have 20 stitches. So 5, 6, 7, and 2 in the same one, so that's 8, 9, 10, 2 into this one, so that's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and it's that same one, 16, 17, 18, and then again, that's our last one there, so that'd be 19, 20. Sorry about the light, we've sort of, the sun's decided to disappear on me, so we'll keep going as best we can. Okay, so now I'm going to pull forward my yarn, back, to make my mark. And then we're going to do one double crochet into the top of each one of those stitches now for that last round, so that'll be 20. And there we go, there's my last stitch, that's 20 stitches there. And take that hook out. And I'm going to pull my stitch marker forward, and this time we're going to increase again by 5, so that will give us 25 stitches. So to do that, we're going to do one double crochet into the next 3 stitches, do 3, and then 2 into that 4th one, and that gives us 5 double crochets altogether. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to do that 4 more times until we end up with 25 stitches. So that's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. So there we can see that's where our stitch marker is. So I'm going to pull that to the back now. So now we're going to do, yes, you've guessed it, one round of one stitch into the top of those last stitches. So that'll be 25 stitches altogether. Go, there's our 25th stitch. I'm going to pull the stitch marker forward, and then this time we're going to increase by 5 again. So to do that, it will be, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 4, 5, 6. And then again 4, so it's 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 2 into that one, that's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and then 2 into that one, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 and 24 25 26 27 28, and then two more into that last one, 29 30. And as you can see, we're getting that nice shape there. It's looking like a hat, a Santa's hat. And again, I'm going to put my mark around the back. And then we're going to do one into the top of each one of those stitches. So that will be 30. So there's our 30th stitch in, and if you wanted to just test it on your egg, you can just see how you're doing. And you want to make sure that it's going to come down as far as you want, as it needs to come down. So we definitely need to go a little bit wider, and I reckon that we'll be clearing that egg quite nicely, because you don't want it to get stuck on there, do you? So one more row to get bigger. So for now, I'm going to just increase that by 5 one more time. So bring my stitch marker forward, and then we're going to do 5 stitches, 5 double crochets into the next stitches, sorry, 1 double crochet into the next 5 stitches. I'm sorry. 3 4 5, and then 2 into that one to make 7. 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25 26 27 and 28. I bet you're thinking, oh my god, stop counting, woman. Oh, I'm sorry, this is what I normally do in my head, so sorry, I'm vocalising it. So, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, and in that last stitch we're going to do 2 to make 35. Like that. Okay, so put the yarn back, and this time I'm going to do a round of one stitch into the top, so that's 35, but I'm going to do that twice. So you can either do this two ways. You can count 70, or you can use the stitch marker. I'm going to use the stitch marker, so I'll speed that bit up. So I've just popped that onto my egg now to see how that's going, and I'm happy that that's come down to that level now. So what we're going to do is we're going to start working on this white bit, and I think I just need to go and get another light source, because I think we're running out of light drastically here. So I'm back in a moment. Right, that's better. Sorry if it's a bit grainy now, but it's getting dark here. So I just wanted to point out, to show you the stitch marker and show you how it's travelled its way around around our little cosy. And that just shows you sort of that would have been a seam that you would have seen going all the way around. So it's not like you could have kept the seam to the back. It would have been visible, you know, pretty well much anyway you looked at it. So okay, maybe not that way, but you definitely would have noticed it, and it's nice not to have that visible seam. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we've finished with our red, so I'm just going to make that loop a bit smaller, but we're going to cut a fairly decent tail because we're going to change now to the white yarn. So I'm going to take my stitch marker and just pop that in there now, because we don't need that now. Move that over there, and I'm going to get my other yarn, and what we're going to do now is we're going to join this yarn, but I'm going to show you how to, I've done a video on how to join different colours of yarn, but I'm just going to quickly show you how to join this yarn so that it doesn't look messy, because if I join this yarn now by finishing this stitch with the new yarn, and I just work into here, we can see that that loop there from that stitch is now on the top of that one, and we don't want that because that will be really visible when we come round to finishing this round. So what you do, we're just going to undo this stitch that we did here, like that, halfway, and put the hook back in there. Let's actually undo that whole stitch, but so we need to redo that stitch, so we'll take that out. So I'm going to put the hook through, and not going to grab this yarn, the red one, I'm going to grab the white one, or the cream, whatever colour you're using, to finish off that stitch. Like that. Put my yarn over, my stitch marker over. Now, when I do my first stitch, you can see that's completely the new colour. Okay? So, we're going to do 10 rounds of the white. So that's going to be 350 stitches altogether. So you can use your stitch marker, or you can count them. If it's all going to be one colour and you're not doing any increasing, then there is absolutely no reason why you couldn't just count them. Now, counting is a lot to count at 350, and you'll probably lose your place. So I recommend using your stitch marker, because the phone will ring, or somebody will ask you a question, or you'll hear some music and you'll start humming along or singing to it, and then you'll forget where you've got to. So I recommend using the stitch marker. But now we're using this colour, I'm going to use the tail from the red to become my new stitch marker. So I don't need it just yet, because it's going to be fairly obvious when we get round to here. But just count them anyway, make sure you've got the right number of stitches. I've just wanted to show you an app I use on my phone. And it is an iPhone app, and I don't know if you can get it on Android, but it's called Counter. I don't know if... Yeah, it's called Counter. I'll put a link to the iTunes. Yeah, I'll see if I can link the iTunes app. But it's called Counter, and as you can see, I've got Santa hat. But it has this great function where you can, if you press this I button, you can set how many the steps are. So I've, it's not very clear. So I've changed that to 35. I've named it. There's all sorts of other things you can do. So I don't really use it as much as I should. I don't know why you need all these things, but there's a counter so you can say how many stitches altogether there should be. So if I just press that there, so I've set that to 35. So I can do a row of 35 and then I'll press that. So that's one row done. Then I'll do, I don't know if you can see it, that's a plus button, you see. And then I can do another row and I'll know that I've done 70. And then 105, so you can count your way up to 350. So that's quite a useful app, and it's also got this minus button which takes away the same number of stitches. So if it was easier for you to start at 350, you've done one round, so I've only got 315 left to do. So I'm just showing you different options, and you can set quite a few projects up at one time, so you can, you know, it's not, you know, because we always have more than one project on the go. So I'm not saying it's the greatest tool, I'm not saying it's better than pen and paper, but I actually find it quite helpful and I like it, so I thought I'd just show it to you. So now I've shown you that, but back to the hat, the more important thing. So yeah, I need to do 10 rows of the white. So I'm going to not bore you and show you that, I'm going to come back when I've got the white, but I'm going to use the red as a stitch marker. Right, so there we go, there's my 350 stitches done, and yes, by the magic of editing, it's done just like that. So there we go, I'm just going to test that now by turning that over. So we've got a nice Santa's hat brim, get that nice and even like that. I'm just going to test that out now to see how that fits, and I'm very happy with that. So that's not too tight, so my egg's going to get stuck in there. Definitely going to cover all sizes of eggs, and it's going to come way down past my egg, so it keeps nice and warm after it's been cooked, ready to be eaten. And yes, I'm very happy with that. So put that to one side. So what we're going to do now is just unfold this, and what I'm going to do is, I did on this one, I'm just going to do that crab stitch edging, which I've shown you how to do in a previous video, but I'll put a link down below. I'm going to do the edging, and then I'm going to sew in my ends, and then I'm going to come back and show you how to do the pom-pom. So to make my pom-pom, I've used this clover pom-pom maker, and it's, you can see it's clover, it's very small, I don't know what that means. I think that might, I don't know if that relates to the size or not, I don't remember. I'll put a link down below to where you can buy these from. They come in all sorts of sizes, and this is a really diddy one. As you can see, it makes a really cute little pom-pom. You don't have to make your pom-pom this way, there are lots of different ways of making pom-poms, but I actually really like using this. Okay, so you need to get a piece of your yarn that you'll need to wrap around the middle of the pom-pom to be the same, with the same colour yarn that you're using to make your pom-pom. And I'm pretty sure there'll be a competition now to see how many times I've said pom-pom in this video. Okay, so I'm going to just take my yarn, you pull out the two sides, it has two sides, and it actually comes apart like this, like that. And to start, we start off with one side, so you pull up the two sides, and you just start wrapping the yarn around like this. And don't worry about those gaps to begin with, you just want to get one round done. You want to keep these two fairly straight so that they're sort of level, and you just keep going until you've got a decent size, sort of decent amount of yarn. Sorry, to just get some more yarn there, get this to focus. Ah, sorry about that, phone rang. Okay, so you just keep winding the yarn around and keep going till you've got a decent amount on there, and it's all nice and even. And I actually find that you don't use as much yarn with these pom-pom makers than you would do if you're using a paper method, a paper card method, but you know, they all work, so whatever you find easiest. So you just keep going until you've got an even amount, and even, that's not easy to say, and you're sort of fairly full up here. So I'm just gonna cut that there, and you push that, what's that, that's the beginning bit. So you push that bit down, and then you just repeat that on the other side. Right, there we go, that's fairly even. Just one more twist around there. I'm gonna cut my yarn. Then, oops, not drop it, like that. Did I cut the yarn? I thought I just cut the yarn, but obviously I didn't. Oh. Okay, so then we just push that side down, and we've got these sort of punky looking thing at the moment, so I'm just gonna trim off those edges a little bit so I'm not getting tangled up. Try not to trim my fingers at the same time. Okay, so now we've got this wrapped up on both sides, and we have this this groove here that we can put the scissors through on both sides. So that's what we're going to do, and it feels a bit scary, and because we haven't tied it up or anything, but you know, that's what we're going to do. So you want some nice sort of pinpointed scissors, and you're just going to put your scissors into that groove there, and you're just going to make your cuts. All the way around, and as you can see that you let the scissor go through, you know, follow that groove there. Just make sure you've got caught all of those fibres there. And then the same on the other side. So just make sure, see, look, there's one there, look, didn't get caught. And now I can just trim these bits off. I'm just going to pull that bit out. There we go, get rid of that bit. Okay, so here you can just do a bit of trimming on down the side, and that gives you that sort of ball shape. You see what I'm doing there? I'll just do that here. Just take the edges off a little bit, not too much. And I'll do the same here. I'll stop there. That could go on for a while. Okay, so then you get your piece of yarn that you're going to use to tie it off with, and you just put it through that onto that groove. And if you pull it up towards you, so now you're pulling it through. Get that to focus. You're pulling it through that gap, which you can't really see there, but you're pulling it through. I'm just going to cross it over at the top. I've got it like this, I'm just going to cross it over, and I'm going to pull it nice and tight and pull it up to the top and tie a knot this time. I'm going to let that knot come down through the middle, pull it nice and tight, make sure it's getting down into that middle, separating those two parts of the pom-pom maker. I'm going to make another tie just like that. I'm going to undo these bits here and here. Where are they? Here they are. Here. Pull it out. Give it a shake. Like that. And then I can just trim that up as I need to. And get that to focus. Yeah, so get off those funny long bits. And then you can just literally sew that onto the top of your hat. So there we go, that's the end of my tutorial. I hope you really enjoyed this video. I think this is a really cute little thing to make and would make a great last minute gift for somebody. You could even put that in an envelope, and I'm sure, pretty sure that would go through the letterbox. So yes, I think that would make a great gift. You could attach cotton or threads either side, and you could make that into a hanging decoration for your tree. It doesn't have to be an egg cozy. And again, I've put the written instructions on my blog, so you'll be able to see how to make this bigger or smaller depending on your egg size needs. This is a pretty standard sized egg for the UK, so I'm pretty sure that this cozy is going to fit not an ostrich egg, but definitely run-of-the-mill chicken eggs. So there we go, that's the end of my little video. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'd love a thumbs up if you did. Why not subscribe if you haven't already? And you'll be able to see the videos that I have coming up at least once a week. I hope to do some more in the new year, but we'll see how that goes. And yeah, you can find me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. And I would love for you to come and say hi. Leave me comments down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.